So what we're talking about today is called thunderstorm asthma. And you know that asthma is caused by an allergy against some particles that you breathe in. Now people think that asthma can be caused by breathing in smoke, but it's not really smoke we're interested in. The big issue with asthma is pollen. So here's a diagram of a pollen granule. And everyone thinks, well, okay, that's a pollen granule. But it's very interesting. It actually has a structure inside it so that inside your pollen granule, you might have 500, 600, or 700 little tiny sub-components of the pollen, which is some kind of a starch, but with proteins in it that you can become allergic to. So a person might get most of this large-sized pollen granule sticking in their nose. Probably mostly they would get hay fever. So you might get people who don't even know that they've got asthma. Then under the right conditions, this outside of the pollen granule will just pop open. And now you see we've got millions and millions of these little tiny microscopic particles floating around in the air. And so they're much worse because they actually penetrate right down into the lower airways and have a much bigger effect. So you can imagine if you think about asthma, what's normally going to happen is that your large airway, say that might be, say, 2 millimetres in diameter from there to there. And when you breathe in normal pollen, it might shrink up a bit. So now it's down to, say, 1.5 millimetres. So at that point, the person's feeling not too bad, but is just a little bit wheezy. Now, as you go down the lungs, of course, the airways get narrower and narrower. And so down here, you've got an airway that's like 0.1 millimetre in diameter. And you can imagine that these little tiny ones can get right down into that tiny airway. And, you know, it's going from that size to that size, which makes a big, big difference to people. They can usually breathe in a little bit, but it's harder to breathe out. So eventually, people can't breathe out and these little airways will trap the air and the lung gets expanded. And feel very, very uncomfortable. Usually if you have asthma, you can take some kind of a spray product that will get down to these very small airways and open them up. But if you've never had asthma before, you won't have that medicine in your house. So you really have to call the ambulance and go to the emergency room.